Welcome back, everyone, to Pokemon Yellow. Last time we finished off the Rocket HQ, defeated Team Rocket, got the Master Ball, and yeah, we're pretty much done with Silph Co. Team Rocket is out of town, and there are a number of places that we can visit now, and a number of people that we can talk to. I flew here on my Pidgeot when I read about Silph. It's already over? I missed the media action. Yes, he did. And now, that Rocket goon is no longer blocking the door to the gym. Which begs the question, why didn't any of the gym trainers just bust through the door and attack the guy that was blocking the doorway? I mean, with so many psychic trainers, wouldn't it have made sense to knock down the door and fight off everyone unless they were locked in? Or maybe their psychic foresight just failed to work and they didn't see this coming. Let's see, Saffron Gym, leader Sabrina, and Blue was here first. Yo, champion making! Sabrina's Pokemon use psychic power instead of force. Fighting Pokemon are weak against psychic Pokemon. They get creamed before they can even aim a punch. Well, it's a good thing none of my Pokemon are fighting type. Whoa! Yeah, that's a lot faster than I remember being. Sabrina's young, but she's also our leader. You won't reach her easily. Are you sure about that? Because I'm pretty sure I will. Especially with such a huge level advantage. At least 13 levels above it. Let's go with the Body Slam. And that's an easy one-hit KO. And an easy level up as well! Okay, let's see. I guess I'll switch into Future Find next, so that everyone can get the level up to 47. And another Slowpoke. Okay. Does this guy have 3 Slowpoke? Because if that's the case, things are going to be a lot easier than I thought. Oh, okay, it did not go down in one hit. No need to use Quick Attack, because Slowpoke are one of the slowest Pokemon in the game. As the name would imply. Okay, and oh, Slowbro! Let's see, how much experience does Future Find need to level up? 1451. That's still a bit of a ways away. Let's Body Slam and see how far that gets me. Oh! Only half. Nah, don't want to use Focus Energy, because that was a mistake teaching it that. So yeah, Focus Energy is supposed to give you a big boost in your critical hit chances, but instead, because of a glitch, it actually reduces your critical hit rate by 75%. Yeah, that's a pretty big oversight. And no level up for Future Find this time. Perhaps in the next battle. Okay, that takes care of the first psychic. I lost my concentration. There used to be 2 gyms in Saffron. Fighting Dojo next door lost its gym status when we went and creamed them. I guess I'll have to pay that place a visit afterwards. Okay. There are, I believe, 7 trainers to fight here, plus a gym leader, since this gym is laid out in a 3x3 grid with two of those rooms being occupied by the entrance where there are no trainers and the center room with the gym leader. You and I, our Pokemon shall fight. Okay, oh wait, this is a channeler. I'm pretty sure, yep, that's a channeler. They specialize in ghost types. So, in Koga's gym, which was supposed to be a poison type gym, there were tons of psychic Pokemon. And in Sabrina's gym, which is meant to be a psychic gym, there are poison types. I think these trainers got a bit confused. And so did Tsunami. Oh yeah, and Lick. That brings up an interesting thing. Ghost types are supposed to be super effective and the biggest counter to psychic types. Just like with focused energy, the opposite is true for psychics versus ghosts. In multiple ways, in fact. Moves like Lick and Nightshade, which are the only ghost type moves in the game, are supposed to be super effective against ghost Pokemon. They don't even affect them, not one bit. And because there are only three ghost Pokemon, Ghastly, Haunter, and Gengar, all three of them are part poison type as well. And guess what's weak to psychic? Poison. So, yeah, what was supposed to be Ghost's biggest, or Psychic's biggest counter became a laughingstock when pitted against a Psychic type. And it doesn't help too much that the other weakness to Psychic being Bug is not any better off than the Ghosts are. I lost after all. I knew that this was going to take place. Let's see, Future Find, you still need to level up after 479 experience. I'm just gonna keep going this way. And almost to ignore this guy completely. Does our unseen power scare you? Not really. So anyway, the bug type is slightly better off than the ghost type as far as moves go, but most of them aren't even that good to begin with. There's Leech Life, which I don't think any bug type Pokemon even learns. The most you'll be seeing for using that move are Zubats and Golbats. And then there's Pin Missile, which only Jolteon gets to learn. And that's an electric Pokemon. And even then, the only other offensive bug-type move is Twin Needle, and that's exclusive to Beedrill. Which, you've seen me use that in battle before. In fact, I took on this very same gym with a Beedrill in a past LP. So you should know how that turned out. Actually, it turned out pretty good. Let's see, Swift. I've still yet to decide who I should give that Carbos too, and that thing survived Swift, so I guess I'm gonna switch up to Thunderbolt. Ah, crud. I already used up my conversation topic for this place last episode while I was still stumbling through the Silphco building. What the crud? Kadabra, this thing does not have the best of defenses and... Oh, of course, recover. Incidentally, if you're just above half health and you try to use recover, it'll fail. Or is it just under half health? Because I know it heals half health. Okay, let's see, what else do you got? Oh, that was it. I never foresaw this. Psychic Pokemon for your only bugs. Well, now that I think about it, that statement is kind of true. Let's go this way and fight you. I already fought you. Let's go over here then. There we go. You know that power alone isn't enough. Yeah, it also takes some strategy, some speed, knowing what you're doing. Power is a very good element towards it, though. Like so! Hey, you didn't specify on what type of power. Oh, and barrier. Yeah, that boosts the user's defense greatly. And can be used up to 5 times to really increase your defenses. Good thing I was using a special move. Okay. Come on, let's get onto his next Pokemon. And it's a Kadabra. I think I'm gonna use Swift on it. Since its defenses are super low. So low that I almost one-shotted it with Swift. Yeesh. Okay, let's quick attack that thing. Before it can get a chance to recover. And got an unnecessary critical. Almost thought that Thundra was gonna get a level up by the experience all gains. I don't believe this! Springy just wiped out the Cry Master next door. Oh, so that was a recent event. And I'm back to square one. Okay. I'm just gonna keep going this way. Am I just going around in a circle? Okay. I'm going to go here. There we go. Saffron Pokemon Gym is famous for its psychics. You wanna see Sabrina? I can tell. You don't need to be psychic to know that a trainer foreign to the town wants to challenge its gym leader. Oh. Okay, it's Slowbro. I don't remember how good its defenses are. But I know its speed is really, really low. So close. Okay. You know what, just to taunt it, I'm gonna use a physical attack. And there we go, 48. Not bad, not bad. Is anyone else going to level up from experience all? Oh wow, they're getting 100 each. At the very least. Arrgh! Seems like a lot of people lately are trying to be pirates. That's right, I use telepathy to read your mind! I wasn't even thinking that thought. Let's see... This is probably not Salad's battle. Especially because... Poison type. How much does Ultra Flame need, though? Oh wow, that's probably one or two more battles left to all that level up. Hello! Sabrina is younger than I, but I respect her. Good, as you should. I think we're almost done here, actually. And of course, back to Channelers with Ghastlies, and... half of my Charizard's current moveset is completely useless against it. So I'll just go with Flamethrower and somehow miss. So yeah, that is a move that will do absolutely nothing to a ghost. Okay, there we go. Not to a ghost, to a psychic type. Alright. Or maybe this might take like 3 battles to get him to level up. Because that only gave me like 100. I wasn't really paying attention when I got the experience. Uh-oh. That can potentially paralyze, but thankfully it didn't. Alright. Okay, that was more than enough. Alright. Some more experience is always welcome. And there we go. Not good enough. In a battle of equals, the one with the stronger will wins. If you wish to beat Sabrina, focus on... What the crud? Focus on winning. Okay. On to the next room. Which I've already cleared. There we go. And I... Oh, I keep forgetting to switch. Hold on. Pokemon take on the appearance of their trainers. Your Pokemon space must be tough then. And just one. And it's a Haunter. Oh well. Time to Flamethrower. Throw those flames into a burning pillar. Dream Eater. That is a healing move, similar to Mega Drain, however, it has a catch. The opponent has to be asleep first, before it can be used. So it can drain the sleeping foe's HP, doing damage and healing the user some HP. That was probably a poorly worded sentence right there. Ah, whatever. We won this battle, so let's keep on moving. I knew it! I must teach better techniques to my Pokemon! Okay, before I continue, switch to... Sumo King. Unless I come across another channeler. Whom I've already defeated. Same with that one. And that one. And this one. Oh! Okay, that was... Alright. I'd better heal up. With these super potions I've been keeping along with me this whole time. Okay. For all I know, I might need this. Plus, it helps free up inventory space. Or not, because I still have one more potion left. Why do I have the bicycle there when I could have it right here? And I could have this here, just in case I need to go with the strategy of rest. So, Thunder, are you ready for this gym battle? Oh. I don't think I've seen that one before. I have a vision of your arrival. I have had psychic power since I was a child. I first learned to bend spoons with my mind. I dislike fighting, but if you wish, I shall show you my powers. And Sabrina, the gym leader of Saffron City. Starts off with an Abra at level 50. Kinda overkill, if you ask me. I mean, why does she need an Abra at that level? It should be a Kadabra at the very least. And, oh, I thought it had teleport. Maybe it does. And Flash, that lowers the accuracy of the opponents. Does no damage, just causes things to be slightly more annoying for the other person. Because they'll be more likely to miss. And her second Pokemon is Kadabra. Also level 50. That I can respect a lot more than a level 50 Abra. Ooh. Psywave. Does a random amount of damage, either by 50%, 100%, or 150%. Essentially, a random, not very effective, normal damage, or super effective equivalent. So it's not very reliable, especially since it only did 6 damage to Sumo King. And here's the ace in the hole, Alakazam. Again, level 50. Which is kind of a huge leap up, especially from her trainers. None of which were even at level 40. I think. That one did a moderate amount of damage. But its low defense stat causes it to go down in a single hit. Jeez, that's a lot of experience. Okay. And there we go. I'm shocked, but a loss is a loss. I admit I didn't work hard enough to win. You earned the Marsh Badge. 49.50, jeez. The Marsh Badge makes Pokemon up to level 70 obey you. Stronger Pokemon will become wild, ignoring your orders in battle. Just don't raise your Pokemon too much. Wait, please take this TM with you. And TM 46, which is Psywave, uses powerful psychic waves to inflict damage. Hold on. Everyone has psychic power. People just don't realize it. Okay, so... oh jeez, we gotta go back through all the way. And now... oh wow, 888-64 for my pokes. Now we've got 6 badges. These next two can be done in pretty quick succession to one another, actually. But before we do that, I'm gonna take a bit of a detour once I figure out a good path through this place. Oop, no. Don't want to go back through the same one I just entered. Okay. Am I getting close? There we go! Psychic power, huh? If I had that, I'd make a bundle at the slots. Not that kind of psychic power. Let's see, and... yep, now I'm confirmed as a winning trainer. Okay, I'm back. Just had to help out with something real quick. Now, the Fighting Dojo. Some of the members of the... some of the gym trainers talked about how they took on the Fighting Dojo and took the gym leadership from them. Why don't we go give them a quick little visit? Fighting Dojo. Yeah, it's a small set of 5 trainers. Hoo-ha! You're trespassing in our Fighting Dojo! All of which specialize in fighting types, as the name would imply, from these back belts. These black belts, not back belts. What even is a back belt? Is that even a thing? Oh man. Yet another goofy slip of the tongue to make an entirely different word from what was clearly on screen. Seriously, how did I turn black belt into back belt? Oh man. So yeah, we've got things like Machops, Mankeys, probably the occasional Primeape. And also a couple of rare fighting types that we'll be seeing at the end of this. Oh, speaking of Primeape. They kind of referenced this area in the show with a Pokémon fighting tournament that was exclusive to fighting types. And the two rare Pokémon that are at the end of this area were pretty much the highlights of the episode. So, although it was a nice little pseudo-reference to this place, I don't think this place was changed in the slightest. Prime Fighters Across the Land train here. And, man, this color palette is very weird for this place. I hear you're good. Show me. Okay, I'll show you my moves. Mr. Backbelt. Okay, I don't think I can take them seriously anymore if I keep calling them back belts. Oh, nice. And Sumo King is definitely gaining a lot of experience here. As well as everyone else. Wait, were they alternating between 47 and 48? And there's that weird-looking Machoke again. And there it goes. Just as quickly as it got here, it left. Let's see. 81, 81, 81, 81, and 81. Okay. Judge, 1 point! Our master is a pro fighter. Nothing tough frightens me. I break boulders for training! Okay. And I rock... and I wreck rock types for a workout. Oh, and here we go. We've got ourselves a Primeape on... I guess... on the field. And these guys really do like using the X items. I do have a plan for that X accuracy that I found in Silphco. It won't be coming into play for quite a while, but keep in mind that I will be using it later on. And that's all he had. Yow! Stubbed fingers! The only thing that frightens us is psychic power. Arrgh! Take your shoes off! Oh, I get it. I think I understand why he says it. It's because they don't want you to track dirt or rocks onto the arena floor, which could cause potential injuries to your feet, because most martial arts tournaments take place when people are barefoot. So they wouldn't want anything like rocks or stuff on the arena that could potentially scratch up or even puncture your feet. So it's all in with good intention. And another Mankey. Ooh, and it outsped me. Now that's actually kind of ironic considering I expected Sumo King to be getting outsped by practically everything, and now I'm the one outspeeding them with Sumo King, especially because of his low speed stat. And that low kick didn't do quite as much damage as I thought it would, because it does more damage based on how heavy the opponent is. And focus energy, he's making it harder for himself to get a critical. And it goes down in one body slam. Just like everything else. This really is Sumo King's time to shine here. Especially considering he's up against his own weakness. I give up! You wait till you see our master. I'm a small fry compared to him. Really? You hear that, Joker? I'm the Cry Master! I am the leader here! You wish to challenge us? Expect no mercy! So now, I guess he's kind of like a pseudo-gym leader of sorts. He's got two Pokémon. The Kicking Fiend Hitmonlee. And I got two Body Slams left. Might as well... Ooh, Rolling Kick. I don't remember what that one does off the top of my head. I think it might be a multi-hit move. We won't be finding out right now, but... because I just took him out. Okay. Everyone's gaining 87 experience. Nice, nice. Good to see that. And the punching pro, Hitmonchan. I don't know if that's actually his nickname, but... ooh, Comet Punch. It's essentially a punching version of Double Slam, where it can hit up to 5 times. And there he goes. Nice! What a way to go, finishing off this place with a level up. And wow, only 47 in speed. And yet I was outspeeding almost everything here. Ooh, Double Edge. Nah, I'm not gonna use that. Although... nah. I was thinking, it does do recoil damage to the user, which I can heal off of rest. But I think if I'm going to replace Amnesia with anything, it's probably gotta be with Hyper Beam. Ha! Arg! Beaten! Indeed, I have lost. But I beseech you, do not take our emblem as your trophy. In return, I will give you a prize to fight in Pokémon. Choose whichever one you like. Okay, what do you think, Thundro? Oh! He's really excited for that victory. Let's see... Hitmonlee, the kicking Pokémon. You want the hard-kicking Hitmonlee? Nah, let's see what the other one is first. Or Hitmonchan, the punching Pokémon. Do you want the piston-punching Hitmonchan? Nah... now, I'm going to pretty much be getting both of them, essentially, but I'm only gonna pick up this one. Hitmonlee. The hard-kicking Hitmonlee is coming with me. No thanks. No more room for Pokémon, Hitmonlee, blah 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 blah, box 2 on PC. Enemies on every side. Better not get greedy. Let's see. Huh! Stay and train at Cry with us. Sorry, no can do. So, with that, I think that should be enough for this episode of Pokémon Yellow. I'm gonna go heal up, and next time we're going to be taking care of one last thing here in Saffron City before heading out for, oops, excuse me, for the next area. See you then!